गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, एम आई ऑडिबल? ओके ओके, यस यस, गुड इवनिंग। एक्चुअली देयर इज लाइट प्रॉब्लम, आई थिंक सप्लाई इज नॉट देयर, सो इट गॉट अ लिटिल बिट डिलेड। ओके, सो यस्टरडे यू ऑल ट्राइड टू अटेम्प्ट द test that I gave you, and in comparison to previous tests, a few students skipped it, and I understand that the time shortage was there and it was only for 10 minutes, so you might have faced difficulty attempting 10 questions in 10 minutes at the same time typing your names, but anyway, try to do that. Practice it in next classes or in next test. Try to do it quickly, because in most of the examinations I have seen that sometimes you have to attempt 100 questions in 1 hour. As SSC used to do this thing, in SSC examinations you have to attempt 200 questions in 2 hours. So in half an hour you have to attempt 50 questions. And if we count it, it goes to 35 to 40 seconds for one question. So I thought that the time was sufficient if we keep in mind the competitive examinations. Okay, but yeah, for you people, especially for the beginners, it might have been difficult to manage time in just a very short period, a limited period of time. Anyway, many students tried to attempt it and they have attempted it. That is what good. Now we are moving to the next topic. As I propose into the course layout, the next topic is on Victorianism or Victorian period. There is difference between Victorianism and Victorian period. Might be into the discussion I shall deal with the issue. And so far we have discussed from the Dark Ages to the Romantic period. And now we move to the Victorian period. What Victorian age is all about and what it is famous for. If you see literature of the Victorian period, you will find two major forms that were very popular, and the other form that was roughly popular, we cannot say it was the least popular, but it was popular at that time. But drama was absent. Since the 18th century, sentimental comedy, anti-sentimental comedy, these were the comedies that were written into 18th century, but they could not create any landmark. They could not become so important. And this was called the decline of English drama. And in the 18th century, in the 19th century, we hardly find any drama that was very successful. So, in a nutshell, if we say, whole 18th century and 19th century, barring a few exceptions, was not the age of drama. So, three major genres of literature that were very popular into this period of time of 200 years, it was poetry, novel and prose. In the 18th century, prose was becoming popular, and in the 19th century, prose established itself as a major genre. But see, from prose developed novel. We discussed the beginning of novel in brief with the work of Samuel Richardson, Pamela and Henry Fielding, Joseph Andrews, all these things. Now we move to the Victorian period. And its beginning has a very complicated idea. Like sometimes if we look at historical fact, this Victorian period starts with the enthronement of Queen Victoria to the monarch of England in 1837. But before that, so many things happened, and that led to the beginning of the whole notion of Victorian ideology or Victorian society of England. That is called Victorian society, but things happened earlier. Like you have read about Industrial Revolution in the beginning, two discussions, two lectures in the 18th century and in the Romantic period. Industrial Revolution changed the whole concept of cities, and London being the major city of literary, intellectual and cultural evolution of England, this city went through a transformation from a very traditional society. It progressed within 100 years to become a very, you can say, metropolitan city. And here all kinds of people started settling: businessmen, thieves, robbers, literary authors, publishers, tradesmen, even colonialists, many kind of people. They settled into London, and London became the, in simple word you can say, it was the capital, all kinds of capital, financial, economic, social, political capital of British Isles. And this is what makes London very important in many respects. What Victorian society is about and what we study, if we study Victorian age, especially in literature, we study the city life mostly. What influence it had on common life, like you have read the novels of Charles Dickens, they are all the products of a city that has gone through a huge transformation. It has become overcrowded. The problem of management, administration, law and order has aroused. At the same time, social gap has increased. Some people are quite rich. I mean, you can say very rich and very prosperous. But some people, they are good for nothing. They are beggars, they are very poor people, and their life ends from beginning to end, from birth to the death, being caught into poverty and misery. Nothing happens, or their life is not going to change. So this Victorian society, on one hand, it is this. On the other hand, the Victorian society has seen positive side of the development of so many things into English society, like the advancement of science and the loss of faith. Doubt has arisen into the mind of people. They have started questioning things. Industrial Revolution of the 18th century and Enlightenment, empiricism and rationalism that we discuss in the neoclassical period, it brought two ideas at the same time. One, that science can explain everything, and the other, that God's empire started shrinking. Bhagwan ka jo empire hai, wo khatam hone laga hai, wo sikulne lagta hai. God doesn't have that power, that control over human life that science has at the moment of time that we are discussing, especially into the Victorian society. And in that way, people started redefining everything. We mentioned into Renaissance period, that Renaissance period is called the early modern period. And this early modern period continues. The spirit of Renaissance does not die in the neoclassical period or Romanticism, no. Spirit still remains there, and people did not stop the lust for knowledge. Yes, things changed and priorities changed time to time and age to age. But society was moving ahead. And this also is termed as the era of humanism, when man was in the center of every activity. Humanism came in Renaissance period, and from the Renaissance period it continued. Human society progressed, and it thought only about human welfare and human development. What was the Industrial Revolution? It talked about the material growth of man. Here man means humanity, At the same time, it did not care about anything else, like the animals, plants, and it exploited. There is one word that is used generally to define the present age. The students of geography might be knowing it. It is called Anthropocene, like Holocene, Pleistocene, Eocene. There are so many ages into the history of geography. This current age is generally known as Anthropocene, when man is influencing changes into this whole global world, like on the whole earth. Man has caused disasters, man has caused so many different kinds of natural and social and man-induced calamities. Because man has started interfering, discovering, explaining natural philosophy, natural sciences. Until the Victorian age, people did not categorize two sciences. And this was in Victorian age, especially when people started thinking separately about two fields of knowledge. One is called the human sciences, and the other is called natural sciences. Can anybody try to define what is human sciences and what is natural sciences? Do you know the difference between these two sciences? Now we have so many other sciences. Yes, social sciences, science, pure science, physics, chemistry, yes, very good others. So this was the time when people started thinking into two terms. Like there is one field of study that deals with human subject, and the other field of study talks about metaphysics. And what is metaphysics? When you go into philosophy subject, you will find that metaphysics is what we cannot see with our eyes, which exists in some world which is not part of our daily activity, though it may be part of our daily activity, but we cannot see it. It is abstract, like the law of gravitation Newton introduced, the law of motion that Newton introduced. And what Victorian society made, especially the development into the field of sciences or natural sciences, it was remarkable. One good scientist of this period was Charles Darwin. There was also a great scientist of this period, I am missing his name, but he made his researches into the field of geology. The students of geography might be knowing that. He was, I think I am missing his name. Then we have other philosophers, scientists who